Our topic for today is about volume of solids. Prisms and cylinder will follow the same formula for the volume, which is area of the base times the height of your solid. The big B signifies the area of the base of the solid. The H is the height of your solid. So let's look at all the examples over here. This first one is called a right triangular prism, because the edge or the edges are perpendicular to the triangular base. This right here is not. Therefore, it is called an oblique triangular prism, where the altitude or the height of this prism will be found outside, like so. This is called a right hexagonal prism because, again, the edges are forming perpendicular perpendicular angles to the base, and they're forming 90 degrees angle, as well as the shape of the base is a hexagon, or the bases are hexagons. There are two bases here, the top and the bottom. In this particular case, it's called a right trapezoidal prism, again, because the edges are perpendicular to the trapezoidal base, and there are two bases, the one on top and the one below. Before we move on, I would just like to emphasize some things to you. So these are your edges right here. These are your vertices right here. Therefore, in this particular example, I have a total of 12 vertices, 6 on top and 6 below. Here, I have 8 in total. Now, let us move on. It might be helpful to memorize some of the basic formulas for volume, such as that of a cube, which is s to the third power, side times side times side. A rectangular prism is given as length times width times height, and a cylinder is pi r squared times the height of your cylinder. The next ones are the pyramids and the cones. Pyramids and cones share the same factor of 1/3. For the pyramid, it is 1/3 times the area of the base times the height. Just for emphasis, a pyramid is also named after its base. A pyramid may have a square base, a hexagonal base, a pentagonal base, or a triangular base. So, going back to the volume, whatever that base is, get the area of that multiplied by the height of the pyramid and then divide it by 3, or multiplied by 1/3. The same principle is applied to cones. In this case, big B is pi r squared, and then h is the height of your cone. Divide that by 3, you're going to get the overall volume of that cone. The next shape that we have, or the next solid that we have, is a sphere. Formula for the volume of a sphere is given as 4/3 times pi r to the third.